What's up, guys, and welcome back to the Proto 2 National Cup here on the Pro Dota English channel. It's going to be game two between Team Bulgaria and Turkey. They have a flag now. That's actually pretty cool. I wonder if you just search Turkey country on Google Images, if that's the first thing that comes up. No. Oh, here's Turkey. Hold on, guys. This is very important because it's actually not there at all. So it must have been something that Klizniki just whipped up. Or had on his computer or something, because I just see images of a pretty good-looking country. But either way, it's going to be game two. Turkey did win game one pretty easily at that. Team Bulgaria had a kind of soft strategy and never really got off the ground. So when your enemy's strategy doesn't work out, just inherently because they can't get enough farm from their lanes, yeah, usually you're going to be going off pretty easily. So I said in the last moment of the last game, for Team Bulgaria, really would like to see them mix up the draft in some big way. Their strategy was the strategy that you kind of want to go for in this day and age in Dota 2, but it's not one that they actually drafted properly, I think. Grabbing a Tusk first is not a bad way to start, but I expect to see an Io as the counter pick here from Turkey. Io Winter Wyvern? No, that's probably a little bit... You don't want to grab your two supports like that, especially, I mean, Winter Wyvern's good against Io, but it's a slaughter instead for Turkey now. Okay, and a Queen of Pain, so this is going to be maybe one of those games where you just beat the enemies and their strategy fails, so you show them how it's done. Slaughter is, again, a hero that you don't kind of want to build around. Queen of Pain is a hero that can buy a lot of space, so if your slaughter is suffering, you kind of want to have a Queen of Pain on your side, then a Bane for Bulgaria. I already like their draft so much more than last game. Have the Bane chill near the Queen of Pain. Make her lane a little bit more of a struggle for like a Templar Assassin or a Windrange or something like that. Yeah, that's a much better setup for Team Bulgaria already. But Queen of Pain is the type of hero you want to have buy space for Slaughter if you need to. Otherwise, once you get a Blink Dagger on Slaughter, get a couple levels on Queen of Pain, you can have a very deadly duo just walking all over the place, killing fools off left and right. Very easy game there for Turkey. Bulgaria have a lot of utility with their heroes, however. Bane and Tusk, both okay versus the Slaughter. Both really good versus the Slaughter. Not exactly as good versus the Queen of Pain, but still can get the job done. Very single target focused. They will need something to set up for, however. Again, you kind of want to have a Nightmare set up, whether that's an Ember Spirit or a Slark or something like that. But just I think getting the mid lane is probably the safest thing here for the Bulgarian side. You know that your matchup is 9 times out of 10 going to be going up against the Queen of Pain. And if you have a Bane mixed in with, like, you know, any other given hero, you could usually lock that lane down pretty hard towards that mid lane. You know, Bane plus 1. And I really hope it's not a Razor again. That was not a good pick. That was not a good pick. By the way, Broodmother actually going to get booted out. I guess it's justifiable. You don't have plans for, like, a Spirit Break or anything like that. Killing off Brood is going to be a hassle. They have a little bit of AoE, but definitely not enough. Io is still in the pool. Aside from that, powerful heroes, the traditionally powerful ones are, you know, kind of mostly out. I don't really know if either side can fit an Io in. I guess Bulgaria can run an Io Tiny in the mid lane, and then have like a Bane plus 1 off in one of the side lanes with a Tusk off. Seems pretty decent. For Turkey, I don't think there's any room for an Io here. They can grab a Gyrocopter third, I think. That's probably their best bet. Then they get a really deadly timing. It won't be a timing with a mechanism involved, unfortunately. But yeah, Gyrocopter's looking really good for both these sides. So I think if Turkey don't ban it out, it'll be a mistake if they don't pick it. So you have to either pick it or ban it here. Letting Bulgaria get Bane Gyrocopter with a Tusk is a little bit too deadly. Especially for heroes like Queen of Pain and Slaughter, who blink in and usually don't have a good way of getting out. So the Gyrocopter is going to be at a premium right now. That's really, I think, the only last real, real big hero that both sides should be looking towards. Outside of that, I'm not really sure what else they should be looking at. I mean, most of the big heroes are already out, with the exception being the Io, but again, that's not really, should not really be a huge concern. Neither side should be really scared of Huskar right now. Both sides do have a pretty good Set of Heroes already to deal with that hero, so I don't expect him to be showing up in this game. And just grab something like simple, like a Viper isn't too terrible either for Team Bulgaria. Be a hell of a lot more useful than the Razor of last game, I can tell you that. Night Stalker gonna get banned out right now. You can still go towards those aggressive heroes. Spirit Breaker, Undying Slaughter is a very effective dual lane if Turkey want to do that. In fact, I would like to see them do that. Disruptor. Never mind, it's a Disruptor pick instead. Dire team pick. Disruptor's a fine hero. I think unlike Bane, Wyvern, and Dazzle, you do need a little bit more of a reason to pick up Disruptor. Usually that reason is the enemy team has a Darkseer or an Io. And we can clearly see that that's not the case. I'm not really sure about this pick for Turkey. If they had a Darkseer themselves, it would be fine, so you get some like pretty broken vacuum combos going on. 10 seconds. Seems like it's just going to be a Disruptor for pickoffs, and that's kind of mediocre. Because that lets Bulgaria get the Gyrocopter that I was talking about before. So I like the opening to Team Turkey's draft, but I'm not really liking this Disruptor pick, especially with the Gyrocopter non-ban. They can still salvage it, I think, if they grab an Undying right now and just apply a lot of pressure to the Gyrocopter. Because the Rocket Barrage does a lot of damage, but when you're splitting it between two heroes with Decay and with Slardar involved, there's not much you can do as a Gyrocopter there, except for hope to God that you have some sort of backup behind you. I guess Spirit Breaker can do that to a very lesser extent, but Undying is definitely the one that you want. In Bulgaria, they have most likely going to be their safe lane already shored up. Looking for that mid lane matchup versus that Queen of Pain. If they go right back to the Windranger, that could be decent. Play the slower game this time. We've seen teams go for just Tiny Bane in the dual mid. 10 seconds remaining. It's not really the best versus Queen of Pain. Like, you'd rather be going up against Shadow Fiend there. Dire team. It's also an option for Bulgaria, though. Gyrocopter, get another support as the last, but Tusk in the offlane. That'll actually be a really solid way to go, especially now with this Earthshaker pickup. It's fine for Turkey, but I don't really see why they're picking up these support heroes. Like, they're okay versus Bane. A Fissure from far range can jump a Tusk after snowballing in. It has some upside, but Shaker is not really setting up for all that much. Synergy with Slaughter is very, very minimal. 5 seconds remaining. It just seems like Turkey are just picking heroes that they're comfortable with. And there's nothing wrong with that necessarily, but generally comfort comes secondary to synergy. Yeah, I mean, I guess they have some wombo combo, but it's not really set up with anything. If they had a vacuum right now, oh man, they would be in the money. But they don't, so you just throw out your ultimates and hope they land properly. Hope Bulgaria's positioning is absolute shit. Which I don't think is going to be the case unless they all go into a Tusk snowball, in which case they're kind of asking for it, aren't they? Yeah, I don't really know. Bulgaria at this point may even like want to go towards the Silencer, obviously. Like, that'll just lock down Turkey so hard. You can't do jack as Turkey once you're hit with the Global Silence. All your heroes are just completely useless. Matchup versus Quap, kind of mediocre. It's fine, but it's going to be an Undying now for Bulgaria. This is another way to go about it. You look at Earthshaker and Disruptor, and you think their utility is very high. Their effective initiation range is very high. Early on, they can't fight for jack. Earthshaker versus Undying is the last thing you want to do if you're Turkey. And, Undying versus any of these heroes is a really bad matchup. Man, this could have been so much better for Turkey. I think if they grabbed the Gyrocopter third, then the Undying fourth. That would have been, like, game-winning for Turkey if they just did that. Instead of just grabbing their two supports right now. Seems like a jank draft from both sides. Not really sure where Bulgaria are going ahead with this type of draft. Tusk Undying is definitely a lane that you can abuse. It is powerful. Maybe not quite as powerful as Slaughter Undying, but it's definitely close. So just looking for their mid lane. Viper's going to get the boot out. Again, just like a Windranger or something like that is fine for Bulgaria. Then Phantom Lancer is going to be banned out. Kluzinki's still looking for his hero. Phantom Lancer very frequently played one for him. But it seems like they kind of need a hero to not go super late. Queen of Pain, especially Necromancer Queen of Pain, is a threat. You can't always bank on him going off every single game, however. So you do need a hero who could contribute a little bit earlier. It's an Alchemist for Turkey. Interesting. A safe lane Alchemist for Turkey? Invoker. And then an Invoker for Bulgaria. Okay. I really like Bulgaria's draft. It's a little bit awkward. It's a little bit untraditional, let's say. But I think Turkey really just messed up by picking up this Disruptor third. That screwed them over really badly. They needed a Gyrocopter in their lineup. But right now, it's Kleczynski actually to play the Queen of Pain and Necroman's Alchemist. Big question whenever you have an Alchemist is, can the enemy team punish this hero enough? I think the answer in this game should be a yes. I mean, the matchup versus Invoker is decent for the Alc, but if you add a Bane on top of that, Alchemist should have a really tough time in lane, at least for certain portions of it. And Turkey, they're just going to play this super slow game one more time, it seems. Bulgaria, however, have heroes that can be a lot more assertive. They have ways of initiating, i.e. Tusk. 10 seconds remaining. Doesn't need a Blink Dagger or anything like that. You could even get a Tornado up on the Invoker. 5 seconds remaining. Long range initiation. Kind of clunky, but it gets the job done sometimes, especially when you're talking about slower heroes like the Shaker and the Disruptor. But yeah, it is going to be Shock playing the Disruptor. Kind of fitting there. We got Necroman playing the Alchemist MDL on the Slardar. We got Kleczynski on the Queen of Pain. RNT on the Shaker down towards bottom lane. Hawkeye is going to be playing the Tusk. Already getting poked and prodded just a little bit. Nickababy is on the Gyrocopter down towards bottom lane. Seems like Stoneman's going to join them as the Undying. Got Mastermind on the Invoker with a hat. Pretty sick hat. Oh, I don't really see him because he's floating off of his pedestal. And Pure Evil is going to be going up towards top right now as the Bane. I don't expect these lanes to stick the way they are. But Necroman, he is playing the Alchemist, and that's... It kind of feels like a Necroman's a hero, or a player rather, who shouldn't be playing hero like Alchemist, just the super slow, patient farming type hero. Doesn't seem Necroman's style, but, man, whatever works. Now, I think this draft, I think it's like 60-40 Bulgaria, but after what I saw last game, where Bulgaria really couldn't get anything done, I'm not really sure how much I like their playstyle in general. So I think, like, even though Bulgaria's draft is better, I think that Team Turkey might just have a better team, might just have an overall higher skill level and coordination level. Let's see how these lanes are actually going to line up, though. Nikubaby is not going to go towards mid or anything like that. Just going to join the Bane up towards top. RNT is going to be their opposition. Shaker will have a really tough time against this. Bane's poking damage is so high, especially going for a Null Talisman first. Pretty common openings for Banes, but if you get a Nightmare on that Shaker, it's going to be doing a lot of damage just with the Banes right clicks. Add a Rocket Barrage on top of that, and you're just screwed. This, of course, means the Invoker is going to be going kind of bare bones, not that much help. But doesn't really need that much help against the Alchemist. Like, you would expect Necroman to have an okay time pretty much no matter what happens. Stare down. Necroman really wants this level 1 bounty rune. However, Team Turkey, they have more than enough to protect him, especially with the Fissure. Literally cannot get to the bounty rune anymore. So, yeah, that was well worth the mana for RNT. It's carrying Necroman 500 Gs. And they got the Disruptor to get his bounty rune. Now he's actually trapped and taking right clicks. Shock in a lot of trouble right now. He's decayed. He's just getting it beaten down. Shock now has to run. Hawkeye just needs one more attack right now. He's getting Clarity up. Field does go up. And Shock... Oh, he's going to get a little bit of distance right now. He has to head down to the south. He's going to try to eat some tangos and juke. Juke, so far successful, as Kleczynski is actually going to run to them. Blink away, and Shock's going to live. Those are great shards by Hawkeye, but just not quite enough damage afterwards. Not really sure where the Undying was. I guess trying to fight with the Queen of Pain. MDL sticking around here. What is going on? Wait, this is a support slaughter. I didn't even realize. Okay, this is... What the hell is happening? Alright, so they're going to leave the Gyrocopter up for the top lane, seeing very weak lane opposition in the form of Shaker with Fissure first. So, or they're just going to rotate Stoneman up there and leave the Bane here. Okay, I like that a little bit. But the supporting Slardar is super jank. This is not a hero that can do anything, especially when he has like the heroes that he's helping. I guess bottom lane it's like possible if you get a glimpse into a crush or something like that, but Hawkeye even has a snowball, so there's no guarantee that the glimpse is actually going to stick. MDL is going to be pretty much just that pure melee support. Would it be better to put him on the top lane and have Earthshaker on the support? Probably. What's done is done. Necroman. Oh, he's level 3. Is he going to grab Concoction? No, he's doing a lot of damage, however, to these two heroes. Mastermind does have Quas runes, but I can only do so much, especially up against the Alchemist. Level 2 Acid Spray. We'll see in one level what kind of build Necroman wants to go for. Whether he wants to go Fast Medallion Solar Crest, grab a Fast Point of Sable Concoction, max that out faster than Grievel's Greed. I don't think this rune spawn is really going to determine it, but he's hoping for a Bounding Rune, crossing his fingers. Oh, he gets it. Easy 270 gold. Looks like he just got a kill right there. It's brutal, man. That's brutal. Now boots up as well. Yeah, this is weird lanes for both sides. With the exception of this roaming supporty Slardar, like Bulgaria, they're not really getting that much. I mean, the Invoker's doing fine, as you would expect, but he's not able to shut down the Alchemist. He needs to be doing a lot better than what he's doing right now. And that's where an Invoker with nothing but Quas runes is really at a disadvantage. Applying any sort of pressure to the Alchemist with Cold Snap, not really going to happen. You need Exhort if you're really going to put the screws to him, but you don't really want to ever go for Exhort nowadays. You want to go for Wex. You also don't want to lose your Shaker. RNT in a lot of trouble. He does have a Fissure. I don't think that's really going to help him that much, though. He's going to run to the north. Stoneman's right on his ass. Rocket Barrage will follow. RNT going to cut his way through. The neutrals are going to get a little bit of help, and it will get denied by the Clap of the Hell Bear. Is he going to get one of these kills also? I mean, no, he won't really get the kills necessarily. He won't. Is he going to pull? No, not quite doing that either. But over towards mid lane, Mastermind. He's in a little bit of trouble because of Sprinting Slaughter with Boots First coming in. The Crush angle looking pretty good. He's going to instantly Ghost Walk. That means Necroman is going to stun himself. Which is a little bit unfortunate for the Alchemist. But he forced out an Invoke of the Ghost Walk here for Mastermind. That's fine in itself as long as they can get away. They're going to, however, run into Hawkeye. Shards are available. And Snowball is going to slow down MDL. But he does have a Crush. And Decay will miss. So everyone should walk. MDL's going to get trapped. But Hawkeye, this is not a Disruptor we're talking about. This is a Slaughter. With Alchemist support, Acid Spray is on the deck. Now the Concoction doing big damage to Hawkeye. The beatdown is going to commence. That should be a kill onto Hawkeye. First Blood, yes, drawn by Necroman. So much gold. Now into Stoneman. They're going to go. Field is going to trap the Undying. This is an Undying, so it's going to be a little bit harder without a gun to blow his head off. Towards top lane, RNT. He's going to take a lot of Rocket Barrage damage. He's a couple more hits, but he's going to get a favorable Fissure block. Immediate TP out from RNT. He's going to live. What the block was that? That did not look like a tight block. By the way, RNT is going to live. Miraculous survival here from the Shaker. We have a 1-0 lead for Team Turkey, and Necroman is not CSing as well as he would like. But that kill and the bounty runes that he's been getting, in fact, two of them, or three of them total, I think, man, is going to keep him neck and neck with everyone else. In fact, yeah, a neck above everyone else. CS be damned, dude. You don't need CS. CS is for chumps. I think he's also having a complete free time up against Hawkeye. Snowball's gonna go in because he's in tower range, but he'll blink away from it. He'll be just fine. My throat really hurts, guys. I think I might be getting sick. Ugh. I blame Russia. And airplanes. I blame that. Now, the stacks are being created for this Alchemist. This is a 1, 2, 3 mediums. Should be a 4 hard. Yes, it is. Oh, man. This is going to be so much cash for the Alchemist. And for Bulgaria, they don't really have great heroes to steal this. Invoker can't really do it. Gyrocopter can, but he's all the way up in top lane. And if you go into the enemy jungle like that, you're just asking to be just crushed. So Necroman started this off at 3,200 gold. So it's going to be a lot. He only does have level 1 Grievel's Greed. It's maybe a little bit early for Necroman to crack into these stacks, but there's always time to make more stacks. Especially if Shock is going to be, kind of hands off in the lane as well as he should be. Same thing with MDL. There's not much that he can do in these lanes. So you might as well just spend your entire laning phase just building stacks for yourself, for the Alchemist. Hell, even for Queen of Pain. Like, she has Sonic Wave right now, so if she really wants to get a large influx of gold, she can do so. Smoke up from Bulgaria. All spotted, however, by a Radiant Observer Ward. Are they going to fight this? They do have the ability to set up a trap, but it seems like they're not going to see this one coming. Necroman does have his ultimate up. He's going to run to three heroes right now. Field is going to go up. He's going to get all his mana drained, but he's ready to get the potion stun onto Mastermind. He's going to take Crush following after Sonic Wave. Only onto Hawkeye, however. Klazinki off the mark. They'll get a kill onto the Tusk, but that should have been two, maybe even three kills. I am honestly not super impressed by Klazinki's play in this set. I mean, the Tiny play did get a lot of kills, but that was... not exactly a lot of Avalanche Toss combos landing properly. And that Sonic Wave should have landed on three. if you just throw it like this. Or, I mean, it's really not too more important here if you throw it like that. Either way, it is still one kill, and it is going to put a brick wall in front of the Bulgaria smoke gank. But that should have been two kills. That should have been two kills. And now they're going to lose the slaughter down towards bottom lane. The Hawkeye just gets a free one. No walrus punch, man. No problem. So I guess they do get their dues in the end. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Kozinki kind of not really playing his best Dota. Mediocre Sonic Wave, say the least. But hey, it's fine. Still, they get a kill. Still, the Alchemist is leading in CS. Queen of Pain and Gyrocopter neck and neck. And now Necroman is going to get into his secondary stack. Still has this really big one off to the side right now. And I don't think Bulgaria saw that with their heroes. They didn't quite go deep enough. But here we go. We're going to have a lot of gold for Necroman. 4,600 gold. Grievous Greed, only level 3. There are a lot of small units here, however. There's something mesmerizing about watching Alchemist farm. Especially Shock. He's going to be happy with this, since this is all his hard work. I don't think this is going to get him his level 6, but it's going to get him pretty close. This is a 4 stack, yeah. Oh, baby. Oh, baby, a quad. He has Medallion already up. Solar Crest should be up after he clears this. Is that 900 gold? I don't know if it is. Probably not. No, with maxed out Grievous Greed, it might be. My math, though. Yeah, it's not even going to be completed. Shock can't get the stack guy. That kind of sucks. But it's another bounty rune for Necroman. Are you kidding me? He's been rolling so lucky with those bounties. Bulgaria needs to make something happen right now. It seems like it's going to be off the double damage Invoker. He has a Tornado, has an EMP. He's going to throw it towards RNT right now. Fissure can't come on time. In fact, you already used it. Brain Sap should get the kill. Nope, right clicks. That'll do it. Invoker is going to grab that one, but it does force out everyone from Bulgaria to come up towards the top lane. They're going to get the tower, yes. I don't think they can get a secondary tower, though. Double damage on Invoker is pretty sweet, but going for a tier 2 right now. This is a lot of extra space for MDL over in the mid lane. The Queen of Pain down towards bottom just to get their experience, get their gold. Especially for MDL, it's going to try to gun for that Blink Dagger ASAP. 2,000 gold on Necroman right now. He's going to join the party down towards bottom lane, trying to push down this tower now. Should be able to bring it down pretty well. I think he has a Sonic Wave once again. They have clearing and then some. The Acid Spray, Scream of Pain, and whatnot. We have the Solar Crest now on the Alchemist. Concoction level 2 is going to hurt like hell. And his stacks, are they being remade? Yes they are. I love it. I love it when teams do this. Get the Alchemist a little bit, get the Alchemist a lot. Even without, like this, the amount of stacks that he's being given right now, Pure Evil also in a lot of trouble up towards top lane. RNT though is going to get Nightmared. He does not have level 6 either. Shock does have a glimpse, so Pure Evil's escape, not going to happen just yet. Glimpse right back in RNT's Enchant Totem. That's a dead Bane. Think you can escape Bane? Not going to happen. Nice kill for Team Turkey. Very nice kill for RNT specifically. Needs all the gold he can get to get Boots first, then Blink Dagger. Getting Blink Dagger on Shaker or Slaughter is going to be at a premium. Buying even more space for the Alchemist, then either one of them can join the Queen of Pain and just wander around and kill things. Money. Unfortunately, not maxed out Acid Spray means that he can't quite clear off the entire stack and then have another spawn. Run away, Necroman. Maybe they'll spawn. Okay, not going to happen. Acid Spray also out of range. Stupid Acid. So finicky. Poor bears, man. 60 gold off of one Hell Bear. So balanced. Oh my god, speaking of balanced, that's another 350 gold. This is just stupid how much farm Necroman is getting. With his skill build, however, you would expect him to eventually stop this. Or at least, you know, go off and be a little more aggressive. But Bulgaria, they still need to be the ones on the aggressive, not going to see any stacks. They have a Haste Rune, still kind of on the Gyrocopter. Necroman's in a corner. He does have his ultimate. He's going to dig all the way through, however. Finding him and killing him now is going to be awfully difficult. Necroman, oh, he does have backup coming. However, Tombstone's going to be dropping as well as a call down. He has his ultimate, but it's not going to save him permanently. He'll fall in the end. MDL's going to arrive to nothing because he doesn't have any mana. Fissure will slow down too. MDL, still with the Urn Tick on him, will fall. That's going to be a 2-for-1 as Queen of Pain actually gets a solo kill on the Tusk by herself in the bottom lane. Not really sure what the hell that was all about, but Shock's also going to show his face. Gets Nightmared. Oh no, Turkey, not like this. They don't have a Grip. They have a Cold Snap, however, that's good enough. Shock's going to get beaten down. Fissure onto 3. Really nice of them, but the Brain Sap will kill off the Disruptor. As Team Turkey lose a lot. Super successful smoke gank there from Bulgaria. I'm not really sure what the Slaughter was thinking. He just kind of walked in with no mana. So, yeah, not exactly a play that you're supposed to be making.
attack.
That, of course, is going to slow down his Blink Dagger by just a hair. Shaker did survive, and he has his boots now, but Necroman going down is a big kill for Bulgaria. Even with the solo kill on the Queen of Pain, not quite going to balance out that past 30 seconds of fighting. Necroman's going to go full-on battle build, though. Man, this guy is... So the guy wants to fight. Sanj coming up after the Solar Crest. Bare minimum giving him a lot of extra HP. But RNT now in a lot of trouble. Nightmare, if it lands, he's just dead. Oh, into the trees. No mana, no problem. TP coming in, fortunately very slowly from Shock. They don't have vision. Could have gotten a glimpse kill otherwise. Oh, Necroman guessing wrong. Sad times for the Alchemist. What a disaster. Once he gets to Sanj, and level 2 ultimate, not sure if Bulgaria can kill him off by the time help comes in from Necroman. This guy is a big Alchemist. They're going to try to go for him. Tornado, going to split the wickets. EMP, not going to hit onto anyone. And now the potion being shaken up. Short glimpse back. Solar Crest. Lots of damage onto Mastermind. Holy Jesus, that was a lot. Amplified damage, Acid Spray, Solar Crest. With the level 3 Unstable Concoction. Yeah. double damage on the Alchemist, kind of unnecessary there, because the Invoker was just so screwed to begin with. Wait, they also got the Earthshaker, though, on top lane. And he also uses Echo Slam. Oh, that's a big mistake from RNT. Maybe thought he could save him, but obviously that wasn't going to be the case. They're going to need a Courier Snipe right now. Panda, no! Oh, run away! Yes! Pandas live! Oh, yes, don't kill pandas. And I hope you get punished for trying to kill off those pandas, because those are endangered, bro. MDL, though, is going to walk right at the cliff, and he's going to get gripped. Glimpse will come in and drop it. They're going to get a two-man crush, kill off the tombstone as well. Potion being shaken onto Eco Baby. Acid on the deck. Sonic Wave through onto three. That's what I'm talking about for Kozinski. He's going to blink forward all by himself, however. The shard's going to fly. Kozinski is going to fall. His backup not close enough. However, now it's going to arrive. RNT is going to close in onto Hawkeye, caught in the field right now. Shards are going to help him a little bit, but not quite enough. His next man is going to find an angle. Nice shards from Hawkeye. And Invoker's now going to arrive, but they're completely blocked in. It's all Mastermind right now. He's going to try to go for Shock, but he's going to get stunned up by RNT. Nightmare now to the Alchemist, who's also completely out of mana. He's going to get woken up by the Earthshaker, but also we have backup coming in. MDL is right onto the Mastermind right now. One more right click on a Shock, because he kind of overshoots. Does land amplified damage, however, the shards are coming with the Tusk help. Mastermind gets caught in the shards, however. He's in a lot of trouble, especially with Necroman RNT arriving back in. Mastermind's going to get one more kill. He does have his Ghost Walk out, but he's still amped up, so they still can't see him. Potion throw, it's going to be thrown with the Fissure, that's going to kill off the Invoker. Hawkeye Stoneman is still around the area. It seems like that should just about be it, a massive cluster F of a fight. But Necroman survives, 4-1-3, and that's really what matters there. Whereas everyone from Bulgaria did eventually take a spill, at least everyone who was in there took a spill. Alchemist surviving in that fight means that he's going to get more experience. And at this point, Alchemist, I mean, he's going to be getting gold. That's pretty much a given. But experience to get to that level 2 ultimate means that he's damn near unkillable now for the Bulgarian side. RNT also with 1,200 gold after all said and done. Yeah, they lost their Queen of Pain there, which kind of sucks. But Kozinski landed the 3-man Sonic Wave in that fight. Her job after that was just, you know, do as much damage as you can and then die. Whatever, doesn't matter. Shards, Fissure, Plasma Field, Kinetic Field, rather. Plasma Field is definitely something else. That's Razor. Yeah, that's a lot of terrain altering from both sides. That's going to be a delicate positioning game. One that you can manipulate very easily. Blink Daggers, Force Staves, etc., etc. Yeah, someone's got to be looking for those things. Slaughter, is this your Blink? If this is Blink, that's definitely not his Blink. MDL is not going to be anywhere close to it. Shaker should get his first. But MDL, you would expect to get his a little bit after. For a support Slaughter, a 23-minute Blink Dagger, that's a fine timing. It's a very fast timing, in fact, for support Slaughter. SNY now up on the Alchemist. Assault Cuirass next. More minus armor. Make him actually invulnerable. I'm not a huge fan of SNY and Alchemist. I feel like it's too middle-y, like too mid-range. Oh, Pure Evil, though, is going to run into Shock. And MDL both not going to amplify Crush. Just Crush. Then right-click Beatdown. There's a Nightmare. There's a Grip. There's a Brain Sap, Pure Evil. Doesn't have any backup here. I was gonna try teleport. It's not gonna happen. Glimpse back. Fissure is there as well. And MDL's gonna wake up. Oh, miss the crush actually. Nightmare gets drawn off, but RNT's gonna get the last hit with a big amplified damage hit. Shockmod, Trouble's gonna lay down his static storm right now. Right clicks, EMP, not gonna happen. And Shock's gonna chase down my zombies. Echo Slam onto three. However, RNT unleashes his entire payload. MDL's gonna walk right in for a crush, kills off Hawkeye. He's having backups coming in from behind. Necroman and Klazinki gonna kill off the gyrocopter. MDL still alive. Will put himself in a corner and will eventually fall. As Necroman's going to arrive in, fighting in the tombstone bad, but they'll kill off the Undying regardless of that fact. Now looking for a little bit more. Necroman has another solar crest. This is very quick because of that SNY. He's gonna put down some acid, and Shock's trying to juke out. Mastermind has no vision here. Has no spells either. I think he's gonna jump in, gets glimpsed back into the trees, into a field, into a stun from Necroman. The beatdown is gonna commence. That's a double kill for the Alchemist. And Bulgaria lose four. They don't get the Disruptor. Big fight for Team Turkey. Even though, yes, they do lose the Earthshaker and Slaughter. Those are the heroes whose items need to come up sooner than later. Again, Alchemist survives. Again, the Queen of Pain gets some blood in her hands, and she's that much closer now towards her Orchid. And everyone involved in that fight from Bulgaria ultimately, again, does die. Oh, we have another snowball in towards Necroman, but he's so fast from the SNY, you can't catch this dude. It's just not gonna happen. Can't catch the Queen of Pain either. She has Blink, so yeah, Necroman's gonna walk out of there easy peasy. This game is starting to look pretty grim for Bulgaria. The Alchemist is getting so much net worth right now, and he's not even going for a power farming build. He's going for a pure battle build, and he's just not getting punished. You would think they'll be able to kill off Necroman if they were a little bit closer together at the time. They would have been able to. Just this time, not gonna happen. They need to kill off the Alchemist. First thing, first priority. But as long as Necroman's next item has some sort of survivability component, doesn't even have to be a big one. There we go, Blink Dagger. That's some survivability if needed. More likely than not, Initiation. I do, in general, like Shadowblade a little bit more on Alchemist, but whatever works, man. Shake up that concoction. Blink forward, Solar Crest, Acid Spray, and then hit with the concoction. It's a slow combo. You can make it faster if you need to. Smoke up right now. I don't think this is supposed to be the play for Team Turkey. Unless they really want to go for Roche, but their mid lane is going to be in trouble. Blink Dagger on Alchemist is strong, but it's not quite as strong as Blink Dagger on Shaker or Slaughter. If you had that, then go for the smoke. They're going to try to go in, though. Knocked down to Pure Evil. Acid on the deck. So he can jump in. Stacks are on to Pure Evil. He will fall. However, a huge tornado is going to connect onto all five. EMP as well as the call down, doing massive damage to the Disruptor. Necroman's trying to take out Tombstone. He'll fail because of the Soul Rip. That's going to be a 2-for-1. Now they're going to look for MDL right now. He's going to turn around for an Amp Crush, but taking so much damage on the way out. One more right click is going to kill him off with the Urn. A 3-for-0? 3-for-1? EMP Tornado is pretty strong, guys, let me tell you. But that was also kind of a weird time to make that play. Blink Dagger and Alchemist, again, is great, but not when you're walking into that many heroes. And it's not like that was even a surprise. Team Turkey knew exactly how many heroes were there from Bulgaria. Or at least they should have suspected that the full team was there. Because you saw a couple of them, you could assume that they're going for a tower push. You could assume that they're all there. If you have a Blink Dagger on Slaughter, you can blink in, crush, analyze the situation, then leave with the sprint or whatnot. But they all lined up for that tornado, and that really was what broke the back. Maybe they could have gotten it done without that, should the tornado and EMP not have landed. But going in super deep for the Bane, walking in to a really close proximity fight. Oh, Team Turkey, gotta be a little bit careful there. Blink Dagger on Alchemist is fine, but he's not invulnerable. Far from it. In fact, he's now completely surrounded, although it seems like Pure Evil might be a little bit more surrounded. Crush is gonna miss. However, the Concoction sure as hell will not. They'll chop down the Bane and now look for someone else. They do see the Undying. Are they fast enough to get a glimpse back? Oh, you bet they are. Jump forward for Klinziki. They're gonna get the Silence, which means no Soul Ripper, Decay, or anything. Stoneman's gonna mech himself, but he will not survive it. Meantime, call down to MDL is going to do a lot of damage from the sprint. The Slaughter still is nowhere close to a blink. They're going to jump forward, find Hawkeye. He'll blink out of there, however. Blink forward from the Alchemist. Going to land a stun with Acid Spray as well. The beatdown is up damage. Oh, the Orchid certainly will be. Third kill now for Team Turkey as Bulgaria are falling apart after a fantastic fight. Can they go for Roche right now? They have Amplified Damage. They have Acid Spray, Solar Crest. They have everything you possibly want, with the exception being Bulgarian heroes dead. This shouldn't be happening. I think going for this is a mistake. You need at least two more kills, or just kill off everyone right now. That's good too. The angle isn't quite there, but they're going to catch someone. Oh, two in fact, with a two-man fissure and the two-man sonic wave. Mastermind's gonna get a tornado EMP out, but he doesn't have backup this time to survive it. Deafening Blast is gonna give him a little bit of space, but it's not quite gonna be enough as MDL comes from behind onto Pure Evil. Glit crushes the Bane, gets a triple kill for Klazinki, and now it's time to go for Roche. What a stun from Necroman, and what a follow-up from Team Turkey. Blink in, or jump in, Echo Slam, Sonic Wave, easy kills. This game, though, is the Necroman show. Like, he has been the one to make all the plays. Oh no, Tombstone's on the high ground. That's actually not good for Bulgaria. First of all, it's going to be destroyed super quickly, but also Alchemist can kill off those zombies. Snowball is coming in. Necroman, Walrus Punch, not quite gonna do. He gets stunned right beforehand. Necroman, he's going to survive it even if he does get hit by it. And then Klazinki up on the high ground. We'll blink down to the lower ground. Tombstone has been destroyed. Klazinki gets to be very careful. He's going to hug the Roshan right now. Going to grab the Aegis, so he's not going to fall. No one's going to fall, in fact, for Team Turkey. Luckily for them, Necroman couldn't farm any of those zombies, but still, they get the Roshan. That's going to be absolutely massive. Yeah, this game is slipping away from Bulgaria. Blink Dagger now up on RNT. Has Blink Echo Slam mana. No real follow-up to that as far as the Shaker's mana pool is concerned. Not a ton of mana on him. Especially since Soul Ring's the timeout. Suddenly no more mana, but whatever. And Necroman, usually Alchemist games are a little more passive. And it's usually the team that makes the space. This time it's just Alchemist busting face for himself. Really aggressive plays from Necroman. Doesn't have an ancient stack to work with, but doesn't matter, man. He's getting so much cash anyway. Translating that all into battle items. Another 2,200 gold in the bank. Blink Dagger soon up on Slaughter. Bulgaria. The Nico Baby is pretty big right now. He's got the SNY, has the Helm of Dominator. It's not bad. There's also an Orc on the Invoker. It's just not quite enough compared to what the damage output they need to do is. Especially when they're all kind of getting picked off one at a time. Looking real rough here for Team Bulgaria. And they are going to take a tier 1 tower in the bottom lane. That's fine. Race is on for the top lane, however. Should not be an easy race for Team Turkey to win. They will have to probably send someone down to the bottom lane to defend that. Although Bulgaria, they're not really shoving super hard down there. This might actually just be a free tower for Team Turkey. Or a free trade for Team Turkey. Yeah, it is going to be that, actually. No momentum towards this bottom lane. Where the hell are you going, melee creep? Dire structures are fortified. Yeah, easy tier 1 for tier 1. And Bulgaria, they're not shoving in the tier 2s fast enough, which means Team Turkey can keep on going. As long as Slaughter survives, he's going to be in the money to get his Blink Dagger up. Their positioning, it's not that great. Shock should not really be the one down here. I believe it should be the Slaughter down here, in fact. But hey, he's going to place an Observer Ward super deep. See anyone coming in? Shock is taking an incredible risk by doing this, but the risk, if they can secure the tower, is well worth it. They should just go in. I don't know why they're not. I also don't know why they don't put an Observer Ward up here. Just see absolutely everyone coming in. They're actually going to fall back. Very curious play. I guess they want MDL to have his Blink Dagger. So close to it. You might as well. So close it so far. Why does he have so many TPs? Can somebody tell me what Slaughter is going to do with three teleportation scrolls? They also need to not lose Klazinki right now. He does have an Aegis. Oh, Ghostwall. Klazinki not quite close enough to it. Hawkeye. Oh, he's going to jump right in. Snowball into Klazinki. Tombstone down the deck as well. Klazinki does blink out. Shock, however, is not going to have the same luxury. There's a nice figure. RNT going to walk right in with a huge Echo Slam onto the Invoker. He's going to get that kill immediately. The Concoction will be thrown onto Pureville. This Tombstone is up on the high ground. Pureville's taking so much damage, however. They'll take down the Bane, take down the Tombstone. Now chase forward for more. Blink Daggers up on the Slaughter. And he's going to go in for a crush on a Hawkeye who spotted Fissure onto two. That's going to kill off the Tusk and Stoneman in both. Triple kill again for Klazinki. How is he getting all these last hits? I don't know. But it's going to be a small price to pay. Only the Disruptor. Now the push is going to go down the other way. They're going to shove the bottom lane as much as they can. They have 4,000 gold on the Alchemist. Oh dear. This is messy, guys. This is real messy. MDL and RNT, they're going to go towards mid lane. Tower half HP already. That creep wave didn't stand much of a chance there. Should be a tower destroyed at least after that team fight. Man, this is not looking good. Bulgaria are kind of jumping into a clump right now. RNT is going to get jumped with the Cold Snap. Orchid as well. Tornado will hit onto MDL. Nightmare there as well. There will Fissure. MDL is going to be able to help from Shock. Oh, that was kind of jank. But hey, that was just a space created type of ultimate setup. That's fine. They're all going to get away with that tower in their pockets. And now a Lincoln Sphere on Queen of Pain. That's actually a really good one this game. Anything you can block from the Evoker is going to be really sweet. Bane as well. Has no Enfeeble. And even then, it's not even the best. Necroman has an Assault Cuirass right now. Soon, because RNT stole his last creep. Okay, that's fine. Necroman will have an Assault Cuirass. There it is. And Bulgaria, what do they have? Still decent amount of farm. BKB on the Gyrocopter is not bad, but I just feel like the rest of his allies need a little more. They need to jump in and get a pick off, then take the fight. Anything other than that, and they're just walking into way too much. Like, the Blink Dagger initiations from Team Turk is what's winning them these fights. Their ability to reposition around this Evoker. They have three Blink Daggers now, and a Queen of Pain with a Blink of her own. They just need Disruptor to get on his shit, then they'll have a full five-man Blink squad. Oh, yeah. That'll win you some fights right there. Running literal circles around Bulgaria. Bottom tier 2, very easily claimed by Bulgaria. Something for them. Gotta get that gold, man. Gotta get that gold. That's a tower. Yeah, it should be a tower 4 tower, in fact. Necroman's AC is gonna make this race a little bit more interesting. Doesn't even have his unstable concoction, or his chemical rage pop just yet. But yeah, easy tower. Now the defense should be commencing. MDL. Amplified damage. There is a Blink Echo Slam right now for the Earthshaker. Glimpse back. Do a Static Storm. Mastermind in a lot of trouble right now. He's going to get put to sleep. However, the Sonic Wave will still cut through. The Soul Orb is going to bring him back up to half HP. The Tombstone is now deployed. Jump in. Echo Slam onto 3 from RNT. He's going to kill off Mastermind in the end. Pure Evil also taking a lot of damage from the Fissure. Will fall. They take down the Tombstone. Now the chase is on to the Undying, who should not escape. Also, the Hawkeye is not going to escape either. It's another 2 kills for the Team Turkey side. They don't lose anyone. RNT, what a big play with that Blink Dagger. And of course, the Disruptor initiation with the pullback. That was also just aces. The Bulgaria, they didn't have a chance to do anything there. Neek maybe left that fight super quickly. He was like, screw you guys, I'm not having any part of this shit. And little did he know, that was the right call. Because Bulgaria, they just crumbled under that initiation power. Three-man Echo Slam, when there's only 4 heroes there, should not be happening. And of course, the follow-up was immaculate as well. This is looking real bad now for Bulgaria all of a sudden. What the hell was that? Looking really bad for Bulgaria all of a sudden. Another Roshan. When's it going to respawn? Not just yet. Unknown respawn timer. What the hell's going on with the Slaughter? Blinking into a Centaur? Oh no! RNT. Fight the Centaur. Jesus, that did a lot of damage. Level 3 Enchant Totem with Amplify damage. That'll get you there. But as Team Turkey, you have to be really careful about pushing these tier 2 towers. So far, the pushing in for Team Turkey has been mostly on a racing basis, which of course means that they're going to be avoiding most of those fights where Bulgaria had the defensive edge. Should they go into that tier 2 or up high ground without a pickoff or something beforehand, they're putting themselves in some serious risk. Because Bulgaria will have a little bit more of an edge when it comes to defending, and we haven't seen that yet. Maybe we'll see another Tornado EMP initiation from Bulgaria, or maybe there's going to be a Blink Walrus Punch or something like that from the Tusk. You know, you never know what's going to happen. It's going to be a lot more difficult for Team Turkey to be assertive with their Blink ultimates when they're going offensive rather than defensive. That being said, they have so many tools to get pickoffs that they just have to be sure to not to get super antsy about it. Like Necroman even is going to grab his Shadow Blade, kind of a late one, and it is going to be revealed very quickly. But either way, it is like this Alchemist can get solo kills super easily by himself. Queen of Pain can get some solo kills as well. You know, Team Slaughter up with any of them, it's going to be very easy killings. However, there is a pretty elaborate trap laid down up towards top lane. MDL is going to charge on forward with the smoke up. He's going to be spotted by 2 heroes. Amplify damage, can't run away with that Blink Dagger. He's going to get caught with it. Calldown's there as well. MDL will just evaporate. Deep Baby, however, does use his BKB charge for it. As long as everyone from Team Turkey backs off, this should be fine. Shocking up himself into corner, however, that's not where he wants to be. Necroman's gonna look to jump in. Potion's gonna be thrown onto Deco Baby. Is RNT gonna come in? Echo Slam onto Deco Baby. Sonic Wave as well. The Gyrocopter will survive for a little while longer, but he's silenced. He's not gonna survive this. And RNT's gonna grab a double kill. Necroman in the meantime, taking no damage. He's gonna tear down the Tombstone. Now into Hawkeye. They're gonna blow him up as another potion's being shook up by Necroman. Stoneman fighting up against 3 heroes will not survive that fight, and Bane won't either. It's a full 5-man wipe as the Slardar traded his life for a BKB charge on the Gyrocopter. That sometimes is not good enough, but this time it was, simply because Gyrocopter was the target focus. They know, Team Turkey, the Gyrocopter is really the only one with any substantial threat right now. Their supports are really good for the lanes, but once the lanes break down, Undying and Bane, like, they need so much room to do stuff in the fights, they're going to be super effective, and they don't have the farm to back that up either. At least nowhere near the caliber of heroes that Earthshaker and Disruptor are, who just, you know, have their big AoE ultimates and are a little bit weaker in lanes. That's the trade-off. You kill out the Gyrocopter, you win the fight. And that's why they blew all of those spells for him. That was like a 2-man Echo Slam, mostly for that Gyrocopter. That was a Static Storm, a Sonic Wave, so many things to kill out the Gyro, just to take that hero off the table. Mission successful. Mission successful here for Team Sharky. They're going to grab the Tier 2 tower afterwards, and now they're going to look for Roshan. This game is looking suddenly terrible for Bulgaria as we're skyrocketing back up to that 20k mark that we saw in the last game. Queen of Pain's going to grab her Aghanim Scepter on top of that, and Necroman's going to tear the big guy down. So in the last fight, Necroman just sitting in the middle of the fight, working down that tombstone with the attack speed, it's pretty easy. Doesn't have to worry about Jack all. Now it's another Queen of Pain with a double life, even a sigil there. Oh, blink forward. They're going to find Stoneman and stun him up and crush him. Another beyond godlike spree extension for Kozinki. 13-1 and 12. Necroman 11-2 and 17. The support's starting to step up their game, but for Team Turkey, I mean, everyone has so much that it's like almost hard to do poorly as any of these heroes. Especially an Alchemist, who's going to pick up a Basher now. But the Abyssal Blade picked up. I think you probably do sell the Shadow Blade. I don't even think you upgrade into a Silver Edge this game. It's probably just better to have like an Eye of Skadi or something like that. Or, I don't know. Get an Aghanim Scepter for Disruptor. That would be decent. Get an Aghanim Scepter for Slardar. It's probably not as good. But yeah, it's gonna... Oh my god. Okay, never mind. Get the Silver Edge and the Basher. Sure. He's almost 6 slotted. He's got Travel, he's got Moon Shards. He still has a little bit of ways to go. There are Echo Slam Aghanim Scepter upgrades for the Earthshaker and the Disruptor. I guess the Queen of Pain as well, but she just brought her. RNT is going to use up to dodge the missile. Secondary missile going to connect her with the EMP as well. RNT is in a lot of trouble. Will unleash the Echo Slam, will do nothing, but they will trade him for the Bane. He's actually going to try to glimmer himself into the corner, and he will successfully survive that one. Kozinki may lose his Aegis here, but he'll get out of there. Shards will still hit. And the Urn, oh, it's going to be fought with the bottle. Kozinki should survive this as well. I cannot believe the Shaker got out of there alive. He does not have his ultimate, but Necroman, he's powerful enough right now. They're going to jump in with MDL onto Nico Baby. Can they bring down this Gyrocopter? Static Storm does go up. Mastermind and Tusk both going to fall as Nico Baby, the sole survivor. Once again, Shock does not have a glimpse. But does it even matter? Nico Baby is all by himself right now. Invoker is going to join the fray. But that's just the slaughter to die. That's perfectly fine for Team Turkey. They can back off all the way right now. Oh, Shock. I don't think that's going to kill him. No, not quite. Glimmer Cape. Necroman's going to want to go back in. Silver Edge time, baby. Jump in. Stun to the Invoker. Bass is on the deck. 1, 2, 3 shots to kill off the Invoker. Necroman's, in the meantime, making no damage. He's going to get gripped off. Someone needs to help him out right now. Vision not in time here for RNT. Necroman may just fall here. He's going to get put to sleep for a little while longer. Stone, in the meantime, going to get picked off as he does come in just to die. Necroman's still alive with the regeneration that he has. They can't even kill him off. Shock, also 30 HP, will not die. Necroman's going to stealth up and go right back in towards Nico Baby. This guy's just not going to quit. Sonic Wave will be completely dodged by the Nightmare. The Fissure is going to be deployed, but Nico Baby is going to pick off this Earthshaker with the Fly Cannon. Necroman, he's not going to get help from that field. He doesn't have a Silver Edge. He's going to fall finally. Nico Baby's going to grab a double kill. Team Turkey biting off a little bit more than they could chew. Reinitiating that last time with the Silver Edge. That was ambitious. That was suicidal. That did cost them a lot, as Gyrocopter grabs 2,500 gold. Are you kidding me after that? That's his full MKB right there. Yes, it is. I thought he's going to maybe buy like a butterfly or something like that. No, that's a full MKB. So Gyrocopter just cashed in huge off of that. And Team Turkey, that was completely unnecessary. Kind of felt unkillable, but I mean, Alchemist can only survive for so long. You need a little bit more time between those initiations if you're going to make it happen. This game's still looking really bad for Team Bulgaria, even after that happens, though. Shock, Glimmer Cape being an MVP. Got Yule Scepter now, four staff on the Earthshaker. And sooner or later, these heroes are also going to get infusions of health from their Aghanim Scepter. Just ditch this one. Queen of Pain, free up an item slot for later. Get Alchemist something to do with his gold. Start buying some backup rapiers or something like that. You know, you never know. In case of emergency, grab rapier. They don't have the Aegis any longer, nor have they taken any Raxes. If they did take the Rax, I could say, okay, go for that fight. Be aggressive, whatever. At that time, what's going to happen? RNT going to get jumped right now, has Yule Scepter, has a Force Staff. He's going to get himself very far away. Tornado will not connect. And Shock, well, he's looking for something to glimpse. No, he actually already used it. Never mind. Either way, that's going to be a lot invested onto a Shaker who's not going to die from that. Now the backup's coming in. Although Alchemist is going to end up stunning himself, so it looks like there should be no fight. They're going to run straight towards Stoneman and not find him. Everyone will back off. 42 to 20. 4:20. Haste. You know, you guys know what you gotta do at the 4:20 mark. 4:20, I guess that's very different. That is not a date at all, or anything. It's absolutely nothing. It can't be anything. I know it's not a date, guys. I know. You don't have to tell me, guys. It seems like it might be just beat down bottom lane time. They should be waiting for Roshan 3 minutes, 45 seconds. It's a really, really short respawn, actually, for Team Turkey. Yes, I say for Team Turkey, simply because Bulgaria shouldn't be able to do too much about that. Like, they can't take the Roshan. They just have to wait for Team Turkey to overcommit. But right now, Alchemist can still Rosh. Get a Vlad's on Team Turkey. I would love to see someone pick that one up. And then, the Alchemist is definitely just not going to die ever. Also takes a, you know, huge increase in damage. It's not bad, either. Another, like, 20 damage, something like that. It's not huge, but, like, he'll pick up the Abyssal probably first. Then he just doesn't need anything. Also, he got rid of the SMY for the Basher. Keep that in mind. Because why maim them when you can just overwhelm them? Seems just better in general. Slaughter can grab a Blink Dagger. This is, Team Turkey turning into the end the game type mode. Gotta restrict the vision, get those pickoffs a lot easier. Especially for Necroman with the Silver Edge. Bulgaria is going to cower in their own base. While, in the meantime, Team Turkey is getting out of control. Big pickup, though, from the Tusk. Heaven's Halberd locks the Alchemist down fully whenever he's disarmed. However, Stoneman, not like this man's going to get completely swarmed with heroes. They're going to mostly bypass him, however, as everyone else is going to chase forward a little bit too far. However, Necroman is going to get disarmed. Does have his rage up, so he's not going to die just yet. He's being focused now by absolutely everyone. In the meantime, Nikovic is going to tear everyone else to shreds. Necroman now has to fight up against pretty much absolutely everyone. Has no MKB for the evasion. Has very little help around the corner. Klaziki does not have a Sonic Wave just yet. Mastermind, though, is going to get jumped and brought down. A 3-for-1. Still a decent fight for Team Turkey, despite how chaotic that was. They should have just taken the Undying off and then just moved forward. But we can see Alchemist just not going to die now. He has the Abyssal Blade. That was also Nika Baby doing as perfect a job as he could have asked for, but the rest of his allies are just not farmed enough right now. Again, the Gyrocopter is the only threat here for Team Bulgaria, so once you know, absorb the Gyrocopter's damage output or kill him off, whichever one, there's not much you have to worry about. None of these heroes from Bulgaria have any significant threat. Really, the biggest threat, I think, is Heaven's Halberd from this Tusk, honestly. Deafening Blast also, I suppose, from the Invoker. They're going to tear down the melee Raxes. He's coming in, it's Stoneman and Snowball. Meantime, going towards MDO, does not blink out of it. What the hell are you doing there? Blink Echo Slam, though, onto two. With the Overwhelm Sonic Wave, that's going to be an instant two kill. Gyrocopter is going to buy back, but Stoneman is not going to reap the benefits of that. He's going to fall. He's going to deploy his Tombstone as well, but it's going to be free gold now for Klazinki. Nikovic is going to re-arrive. Fly can do some okay damage, but him and Pure Evil, they can't do enough, especially when the Sheepstake on the Klazinki side. Fissure is there as well as the Potion. Well, it's going to be dodged right now. They're looking for a Bash. Silver Edge is up on Necroman. He's going to get hit with the Deafening Blast. Now completely tapped out of Mamba. Klazinki is still going to get the pickoff. Now onto Mastermind, they're going to try to go. He doesn't have any spells to cast, and he's going to get stunned up Pure Evil as well from that last hit. That's a 5 kill for Team Turkey, and it's going to be GG as well. 51-22. This was an Alchemist game through and through, guys. Not a power farming one, a battling one. A battling one that bought himself all the space. And of course, Team Turkey, they got their components up afterwards. Team Turkey proving that they are decisively the stronger team here. These games, not really with Bulgaria having much of a chance throughout all of them. That is, of course, going to end our day. This tournament is progressing on super slowly, guys. Hopefully, we can pick things up sooner or later. But either way, I'm Mike Lore. It's been a pleasure casting these games for you. If you did enjoy, be sure to, well, follow the rest of the games, if you can do that. And follow me on Twitter, at Mike Lore. I will appreciate. You'll have my eternal and everlasting love. I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. GG.